Hello, and welcome to this video demonstration showing how the integration between the Agilent Advanced Design System and the Cadence Allegro PCB design environment can shorten design cycles and improve design quality for RF mixed signal designs. In this video, you will hear Dan Evers of Agilent showing the design flow from an RF design perspective and Gary Hind of Cadence from a PCB design perspective. You will see how custom copper shapes can be created in ADS, then incorporated directly into the Allegro PCB layout. Once there, the PCB designer can send those shapes back to ADS, including the surrounding metal, and then the RF engineer can verify the electrical performance.
So for this demonstration, we're going to show a patch antenna that you see here, not constructed from transmission lines. These are just polygons. This has been carefully crafted to have a certain frequency response, and this has been analyzed in our Method of Moments EM simulator momentum. It's got a nice resonance just below 8 gigahertz, where we hope the thing to behave at. And we can look at a radiation pattern and see it's got a nice symmetrical radiation around the patch. We can take a look at this in our 3D viewer, that we have a feed on a lower layer connecting to the patch antenna at the upper layer. It's going to couple through the substrate. So to export this, it's File, Export, and the file is written out. This will contain everything Cadence needs to reconstruct this exact geometry in Allegro.
Okay, so for this portion of the demonstration, what I will do is I'm going to actually import the patch antenna from ADS. I'm going to use the RF PCB module inside Allegro PCB, and the IFF interface I have here will allow me to import IFF layout data. So I'll browse to my transfer directory, and I'll take the layout IFF. I can now also either import the stackup directly from IFF, or I can map it to the stackup that I have inside my design. And there's the patch antenna on my cursor ready to be placed. If I window into the area where we've placed the patch antenna, you can see the antenna itself is sitting on the bottom layer, and the excitation circuit is on inner two. I've got some digital signals in close proximity. What we're trying to show here is some potential problems. I'm just going to turn on my power plane, and what I will do is actually add a void into the shape as well. I'll add a rectangular void, and for the sake of the demonstration, I am going to make this void worst case, so I am actually going to try and clear the isolation away from underneath one of the digital signals. So actually this is a bad practice, but we'll see what the impact is when we take it back for simulation. I'll select done. So at this stage, I'll turn off the power layer, and I'll now prepare the design ready to export to ADS. I then go export to ADS and select traces. So first thing I can do is say pick nets, and this will allow me to physically pick nets off the circuit, so or off the layouts. I can then select these elements and add them for extraction. I can also identify the ground plane that I would like to use for reference, would say add that. And then I would also say include all unnamed nets that would reside within the area that I define. Now I can use what we call a cookie cutter. The idea of the cookie cutter is being able to build an area or a polygon, in this case a bounding box, with some expansion, and I can say build. I'll include all of the elements that I selected earlier, and you can see the bounding box is now ready to go. Last but not least, we'll go into ports, we'll say verify and update, and now everything is green, and so everything I've set up is ready for export. We select OK. Now I'll say export to ADS, export, and at this stage, this is where I would now hand the data back to the RF engineer for him to run his simulation.
So to continue with our analysis of the antenna, it's been sent from ADS to Cadence, it's been integrated into a larger design. And now we need to see if any of the effects from that larger mixed signal design disturb the behavior of the antenna. To import this, we're going to open up a blank ADS layout page. There's a new menu pick here, Allegro Tools, which will allow us to import that type of Allegro export, the graphics, the substrate, port information for an EM solver. And in ADS now, we get a detailed representation of not only the patch antenna, but everything in Cadence nearby, everything that we were concerned about as potential interferers. If we look at this in the 3D viewer, we can see that the relative relationship of all these layers has been carefully brought over from Cadence as well. The patch antenna has been put on the back side of the board, and because of the construction of the board, between it and the feed, there's a plane layer, and the engineer on the Cadence side has cut out a section of the plane layer to allow the feed to couple to the antenna. And this was not part of the original design of the antenna in ADS, and so that's one of the things we need to be concerned about. Is this cutout the right size? We've also got these digital traces, which are uncomfortably close, that we need to look at. Now, to set this up for an electromagnetic simulation, in addition to the graphics, you need substrate information, and preferably the substrate information exactly as it appears in Cadence. Well, that's come over as part of this process as well. We look at the momentum substrate. We'll see that it's already been populated with the exact layer stackup that was used in Cadence, including the thickness, the dielectric constant, loss tangent. So everything that Cadence knew about these conductors, ADS now knows and can pass through its EM solver. We're back from the EM analysis. This it took 3 to 4 minutes to run. And these are the results. In our S-parameter display, we can see the resonance is still in the same general neighborhood, but we picked up some extra bad behavior, which concerns me a bit. We look at the radiation pattern. Since this is on the bottom of the board, I'll need to spin this around so you can see it. But we can see that the radiation pattern is no longer symmetric. And I think a clue to this is that the cutout in the power plane is also not symmetric. And this, I think, is an indication that we need to go back and work with the engineer constructing the mixed signal design in Cadence to rearrange this cutout to get a better performance of our antenna. Probably need to run a few more experiments on this as well to make sure that the digital traces are not an issue and get the performance back to what the original plan was.
Thank you for viewing this video about the integrated solution from Agilent and Cadence. There are also 3 other videos covering other aspects of the design flow, including the transfer of RF circuits, synchronizing packaged parts libraries, and transferring designs with packaged parts. We encourage you to watch these videos as well to get the complete picture of this integrated solution. And if you haven't experienced ADS firsthand, you can visit this URL to get a free ADS trial license.